Hi, welcome to my latest project. It's this gadget. It has this on and off switch and this momentary push button to cycle between 9 different patterns, which I will show you now. First I turn it on and you will see the first pattern. Clicking the button, it's static with different colors. Turns around 3 different colors. And this is the last pattern. And now it will go back to the first one. In my sketch, I make use of an interrupt that immediately triggers when the momentary button is pressed. It will make the changing of the pattern happen right away, as you can see. When I press the button now and now. Okay, now it's time to show you how it all works. I'm gonna remove the lid. Okay. Well, here is a NeoPixel ring, as you can see. And on the bottom, I used hot glue to fix it in place. Well, there are obviously the wires coming from the NeoPixel board. That's a green control wire. Yellow is the positive and gray is in this case the negative wire for the 5 volt power. Okay, I'm gonna remove now the guts of the cup for as far as it is possible because it's connected to the switches that are mounted inside the cup. Okay, gonna try to not break it. It's stiff wires. Well, let's at first start with the power. How did I power this whole thing? As you can see, it's a little battery box, and it inside of it are 2 3 volt CR2032. Button cells, and I will close it now. That gives normally when the batteries are full about 6.5 volts. So you would say, how is it possible to run an Arduino on 6.5 volts if there is no voltage regulator? I will notice. I will show you what I mean later on. But I figured out that when there is a load on the battery, it immediately the voltage drops down to say voltage of less than 5.5 volts, so the chip Arduino chips won't break, and there's no voltage regulator, so it can't use that. So this is the battery, and here you can see the connections of the on and off switch, which I used instead of the on off switch on the battery box because it's inside of the cup, so I can't reach it. I use this one. And here is the other momentary switch. It's a little switch, yeah, as you can see, very tiny. Okay, well, there's a now let's show the processor, the Arduino. Haha, it's a very very bare one. It's a 80Tiny85, and I programmed it via an Arduino Mega as ISP. And ISP is a program, inline serial programmer, I believe it's meaning. And it's a very cheap chip, only $1 or €1 about. And it's programmed, and then I put it in place here on a, and in a socket on a little piece of circuit board material. And well, the backside you can see also if you'd like to see. It's just a few connections. Oh, it won't budge. I'm gonna try to show it. Yes, it's the contact points. It's got the positive here, and here's the negative one, and the switch is here, and between the switch and the ground is also a resistor. You can't see that because it's encased in the tape, and I needed to tape everything because for the it not to make contacts with other parts when I put it back inside of the cup. And isolation is of course very important. I did it as well with most of the capacitor that I used. That is also always needed between the positive and the negative wire that goes to the NeoPixel ring, because that's for safety reasons. So that's a 10, I believe, 10 microfarad capacitor. Well, yeah, there's not much else inside, I think, to tell you. Yeah, the battery, and it also powers the microprocessor, the ATtiny85, and also the ring, the NeoPixel ring. And that's actually it's all there is. It looks like now it's been very easy, but of course it was a little more complicated to find out about the voltage of the button cell battery needed, and if I needed some voltage regulation to go from 6 to 5 volts. And of course I used first a bigger Arduino, and later to test the sketch, etc. I used a Nano and a DigiSpark, that is actually the same chip, the ATtiny85, but it has voltage regulator, etc. on the board. And well, this all makes it happen. I hope you enjoyed my demonstration and my project. Bye!